Two. Good morning. You know, if I'm broadcasting live and it's this early, that can only mean one thing. It's preview day. And as you know, preview day is my favorite day. Today we set up our whole preview hall. Every gun in the auction is set up and on display. So you can pick it up, hold it, touch it, inspect it. You gotta know what you're gonna be able to spend your money on. And this February is a doozy. We're billing it as the largest firearms auction ever held. And that's a fact. It is over 11,200 firearms. And it's everything. It's everything from beginner grade collectibles to a new in the box Glocks, to things you want to go hunting with, to an everyday carry, to just great sporting arms. And things, as we'll talk about here in a little bit, at fantastic price points. So we are open to the public all day today. If you can't join us, but we wish you would. But if you can't join us, please figure us out on find us on rockislandauction.com. Thankfully, there's a everything's listed online, and thankfully there's a really good search feature, so you don't have to wade through 11,200 guns. You can find what you're looking for relatively quickly and easily. But enough looking at my mug. Let's look at some guns instead. Let's flip this around here, and I'll walk you through. So just as if you were here, into the preview hall, that what you're looking at. Insert your Jurassic Park majestic music right now. It's 11,200 guns. And thankfully, if it doesn't look like 11,200 guns, that's because it is meticulously organized. And it's meticulously organized because it has to be meticulously organized. We have to make it easy to find things, and we'll go over kind of the organization here as we walk around. But if you were looking for a lot number, say 950, it's kind of like a hotel. We'd be, oh, well, we'd look at down this rack here, and sure enough, you would be able to find lot 950. But let's talk about one of the probably the largest advantages of these sporting and collector firearms auctions, and that is price points. On this table behind me, New Haven Arms Henry rifle. This one happens to be particularly good looking. We have a really excellent wood to metal fit all around here. A butt plate, an area where you would expect the rifle is set down pretty frequently. It looks pretty darn good. Nice kind of mustard colored patina. You'd expect a Henry rifle to start in one of our premier auctions. They'd probably start, the lowest you could find was maybe $20,000. Here in a sporting collector firearms auctions, you won't find one that's maybe as pristine as that, but you'll definitely find it at a better price point. I mean, $13,000, you're getting pretty close to half price range as far as, and that's a great looking Henry. Case in point, this 66 Winchester. This is factory engraved. In fact, if you look at the sign next to it, this is not just engraved, this is John Ulrich master engraved and signed and gold plated Winchester 66. So soak it in. Look at this beautiful wood. It's deluxe wood, got the piano varnish finish. We don't have the pistol grip, we don't have the checkering, but this is unquestionably Winchester deluxe wood. You can still find gold finish in some of the protected areas, under the lever being one, under the trigger. In fact, you can see that niter blue also that pops. Like, this is a phenomenal gun. Ulrich's signature is actually on the side of the tangs, the top and bottom tangs. And Ulrich, of course, is one of the 19th century's premier engravers. Like, his work is universally recognized. And if you have a gold-plated Ulrich engraved and signed Winchester 66 in a premier auction, you're looking about six figures. I would say easy. Here in the regional, $20,000 to $30,000. So this is a phenomenal price point for someone who maybe can't swing a six-figure Winchester rifle in their collection. You can get a $20,000 to $30,000 one, and you will have an excellent representative in your collection. Now, I know a lot of us don't spend, you know, like the Henry, like $13,000. We're not going to spend $20,000 to $30,000. On a collector firearm. Keep in mind, these are examples at the high end of the scale, but this theory is sound all the way down. Here we have a beautiful a standard 66. Again, a wonderful wood to metal fit. Our buttstock isn't chewed up. This is a good looking 66. 8 to 14,000. A Henry. Again, where we mentioned you might find one, a Henry rifle starting at 20,000. Oh, 9 to 14 in a sporting and collector firearms auction. So it is all about price points in a sporting and collector firearms auction. It's all about the opportunities that those bring. Here you notice a horse of a different color. You're like, well, it looks like a Henry, but it's definitely not. This is also made by New Haven Arms. This is a Volcanic carbine. So prior to the invention of the Henry, you had Smith & Wesson making Volcanics. They took on some investors and made that the Volcanic Arms, and one of those investors happened to be, of course, Oliver Winchester. Eventually, when that company went, when Volcanic went insolvent, he continued, he owned the patents, and made the Volcanics under New Haven Arms. So here we have a New Haven Arms Volcanic versus a New Haven Arms Henry rifle. And this is another great reason to come to these auctions. You can get an education real fast in spotting the differences between one model to the next, and where those changes have happened, and if it's an evolution, like, you know, what changes happened there, or just between models, what happened developmentally. The size difference on these is pretty noticeable as well. And here we have a pretty significant link in the Winchester story, in the link for repeating firearms, and you're gonna be able to swing it for $14,000 to $20,000. That's an incredible price point. You'll notice some of the Henry too. Henry, so we have our barrel loaded magazine, our spring follower. So you get a Henry hop, but that's before it was on a Henry. But you'd still have to do the Henry hop. And oh, why not? Another beautiful Winchester 66. You can still see the Niter blue on that loading gate. That's pretty awesome. And this engraving, it doesn't say Ulrich, but that is incredibly well done. That is detail oriented. That is not heavy handed. That's beautiful work. And you can get it for $14,000 to $22,500. Deluxe wood. That's a beautiful Winchester. On the complete opposite end of the scale, at sporting and collector firearms auctions, you can buy a High Point. You can buy a Springfield. Kimber. Other Kimbers, a 5.7, a Glock, you name it. And a SIG that might have my name on it. That looks good. You can find it all at a sporting and collector firearms auction. And of course, our handgun cases, we keep all our handguns secured in those because handguns are much easier to steal than long arms, but all the way down. Handgun cases, and of course, our racks of long guns. So bear with me if there are, you know, people walking through. Our employees are bustling together. Our doors open at 9 for preview day, so we are actively getting things ready. Here you can see it's not just firearms. We do have accessories, whether it's pintle mounts, tripods for machine guns, saddles and leather tack and holsters, swords. And here's a new one. I don't think I've seen a whole lot of our Native American blankets. And of course, they came from a collection that had a lot of Native American artifacts, so pretty cool to have that in house. I mean, and it's right next to early AR, next to an SKS, next to an M1 Garand, next to more ARs, next to AK platform, next to, oh, maybe not, but you get the idea. Lever action sporting, and this is day one, gang. We're gonna turn around here, and I'll give you kind of the full. So before I do that, I'm gonna open one of these cases. We haven't opened a handgun case yet for a live video, so bear with me. But it speaks to this notion of kind of overflow and price points. So we had in our last premier auction the Dr. Gerald Class collection come in, and an incredible, like, world-class collection of Smith & Wessons, undoubtedly. Well, not every piece in someone's collection is gonna be this pristine, God-given artifact. There's going to be things that kind of overflow into our sporting and collector firearms auctions, which will provide you opportunity to get rare examples from a world-class collection at a great price point. So here we have some, for all you Red Dead Redemption fans, here we have some Smith & Wesson ring trigger, or I'm sorry,
lever action pistols, repeating pistols. We have some of the early revolvers, Model 1s, Model 2s. I don't happen to see any Model 3s, but engraved examples with the original box. Like, that is nuts. Like, you have the opportunity to find those at a really, really good price point. Thanks to Sporting and Collector Firearms Auction. Sorry, I'm going to lock this up here real quick. And some other revolvers. There's a little Remington in the back there. Anyway, so what we've just walked through is one day of auction. Everything from this wall, all the way over, all those handgun cases that we talked about, all those racks, that is day one of auction. That is Thursday. Not all our auctions are 4 days. The Sporting Collectors have turned into 4 days because they're getting so large. The premier auctions we still try to hold at 3 days. So they just run Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Now from here, and all these handgun racks, and all these rifle racks, to that chain down there, that will all be held on Saturday. I am going to give Saturday a miss and go right on. I'm sorry, that'd be Friday. Oh my goodness. You see what happens when you go from 4 day auctions to 3 days. This is all on Friday because that's day two of the auction. Here's a nice little, like I said, it's not just firearms. It's anything gun guys might think is cool, might have in their gun room, might have in their collection. And there's a Winchester marked, probably a 5-gun rifle rack, mirrored back. You can tell how nice my shoes are. And here we are on Saturday. We're basically every display we have is serving active duty. We do have computer stations around, so you can access our website. Like I said, there is a really good search feature on rockislandauction.com. You can find what you're looking for, find the lot, and then because the rest of the auction hall is organized so well, you can find what you're looking for really, really easily. Or if not, you can bother one of us in the React Polos and we will come help you. There's a neat little British brass number.
Yep.
Some neat things. There's a little percussion gun in a little book. For those two who haven't participated in an auction, you should be aware that we sell things in groups during an auction day. So if you're a U.S. military collector and you miss out on the U.S. military offerings in day one, do not fear. We will offer a group of them kind of every single day. So you can see here on the top, we have side-by-side Sporting shotguns, and on the bottom we have pump and semi-auto shotguns. And we walk through and there's still pump and semi-auto shotguns, and the top is still side-by-side double shotguns. There's more pump and semi-auto shotguns, and we will keep offering those, and we will keep offering the side-by-side doubles. But you can see after a while, after a number of lots, they're gonna switch. And here we have switched to some of the Schutzen or target rifles. You can see from the distinct Schutzen butt, big cheek pieces, pronounced cheek pieces, very distinct trigger guards to give a better, more ergonomic purchase on the rifle. And you start seeing some of these, wow, some of the engravings on here are quite attractive. I was noticing one of these shotguns back here. They're quite nice. Get a little. That is quite nice. But anyway, so you can see we sell them in groups. And even then, we'll go into target rifles and things with, you know, palm swells and things like that, that you can hold on to. Meanwhile, on the other side, we've gone into sort of Sporting rifles and bolt actions and lever actions that you can either take out into the field or you can go plinking with and have a jolly good time. Here we have more side-by-sides on the bottom. Here we have more Sporting rifles. So if you miss out on one day of auction, do not fear. There will be more items in that particular genre on any given day. That said, if you're looking for a specific item and you miss it, once it's gone, it is gone. I'm sorry in advance if that happens, but oh man, there's all sorts of good stuff to look at. I get distracted. It's pretty easy in a room like this, but you get some SVT action. And here we've wandered into European military. You can see from here, there's SKSs, there's Mausers, there's all sorts of goodies. Oh boy, okay, so there's a lot of SKSs and Mausers. A little Swiss Vetterli action down here. we'll kind of walk around. Here's the another day's section of U.S. military. And here on this side is more European military. So, and here, I know we looked past the early Winchesters on day one, but here's, this would be Saturday's, part of Saturday's selection of Winchesters, early Winchester at lever actions. And here, boy, talk about price points. Where else are you going to find a turret rifle like this? The answers are Premier Auctions. But if you don't want to pay a Premier Auction price, or if you aren't able to, and you really, really want one in your collection, boy, that's going to be, again, a great price point. And you'll have found it, and you can put it in your collection and tell everyone how cool it is. That said, so more handgun cases every day. Every day we'll have handgun cases, no doubt. As we mentioned, it's not just accessories. Anything gun owners think is cool or would have in their collection is definitely going to be in an auction. Helmets, daggers, bayonets, boots, ammo cans, more daggers, buttstocks, old advertising. And I think old advertising is probably one of the cooler things. So we go here from like World War II era daggers to some rather, shall we say, flamboyant bench rest target shooting. And so here we'll have a whole section of bench rest target shooting, or target-oriented rifles for sport shooting. Oh, I know you guys love a crate, and if your first thought is, I would put glass on that and make a coffee table out of it, that's pretty much the correct response. Lots of Cosmoline, so I hope you have an oven that you don't like, but very, very cool piece. These got a lot of attention online when we posted them. I think part of the cool parts is seeing like some of those old original packaging or documents or some of the original accessories, like the cleaning kits and the rods. And I don't know, to me, that's, it speaks to its originality, where it's been, tells it, helps tell its story. Again, with accessories, as far as some advertising pieces, a clock in your gun room, like if you had a Colt, Colt Winchester or Smith & Wesson collection, those clocks would be very apropos for your gun room, or hanging by your gun safe, or what have you. As you can see, we're walking past a lot of World War II era pistols, walking past a lot of European military pistols, broom handles, Mausers, P-38s, Webleys, Browning High Powers, and of course, bronzes. As I mentioned, yep, if you're going to find it in a gun room, you will find it at Rock Island Auction Company. We sell it all, even very angry hippopotamuses. Hippopotami? Hippopotamuses? No, that's definitely not right. But you'll find it. And our man-at-arms here shows us the end of Saturday. So everything back in this sort of little enclave that we have looked at will have been offered on Saturday, including all our display cases. We are surrounded by Saturday and then Sunday. Shomer Shabbos. And it looks a little sparse, but that's because we ran out of room in our preview hall. This sale is so large that we had to move. We had to make like an overflow area into our production hall. So normally where we do our shipping and photography and some of those other behind the scenes activities, the preview hall has taken over. And I do see one more crate over here. Everybody loves a crate, so we're gonna show it too. But it is another crate of the 5966 SKS rifles with ammo, with accessories, and the crate. Everybody loves them. And actually, collector for, ammunition as well. So, 10 gauge brass shot shells. Yep, we're gonna have those. A box of 43 Egyptian black powder rounds. Yep, we're gonna have those. And I mean, not, of course, these are not just, oh, that's cool, Sharps rifle, original boxes. These aren't just firearms collectors to have in the collection along with the appropriate firearms. There are people, of course, who just collect ammunition boxes, and more power to them, frankly, because I bet you their collection's a lot easier to store and move than any firearms collection. But very cool stuff. I mean, and you, how vibrant the colors are, how good condition the boxes are, whether it's a full box. I mean, And you look at these, and it's just sort of a timeline of advertising and where these brands have been that we've kind of come to know and love. Like, where's, like, old Remington boxes, old Smith & Wesson boxes, you know, Western X, and who bought them, and what did that turn into? An old Colt, 44 Colt box, but made by Remington. Very neat. Very neat stuff, at least for me. Cartridge box collectors, ammo collectors, I get you. It's fun to see those. Not only the development of the rounds, but the development of the boxes, and just see how it all goes. So let's go into the overflow. Surprisingly well lit. Not by accident. Modern guns, and a lot of glare, of course, from that lighting. Lots of Smith & Wessons, lots of modern guns, lots of 1911 platform, lots of Rugers. And that's basically the overflow, and it goes kind of into that corner. It's about that big, plus what we have in the preview hall. It's a nice Smith & Wesson, lots of Colts. We'll swoosh around here real quick, and Plinken guns. Well, okay, so BFR is not a Plinken gun, or maybe it's a Model 100. No, it looks like a BFR. But, you know, some of the Ruger series, some of the Colt Woodsmans, some of the, oh, there's a Browning Buckmark, some of the Beretta Neos, pretty sharp looking. Someone asked where the auction's being held. It's at our facility. This is at Rock Island Auction in Rock Island, Illinois. That said, if you can't make it to Rock Island, Illinois today, because we are open to the public, please come visit us. You will have a really good time and get to look at 11,200 collector firearms. If you can't make it, check us out at rockislandauction.com, because the auction doesn't start until tomorrow, and it's going to last for 4 days. So there is plenty of time to bid, plenty of time to check out what's in the sale, and get your mitts on something fun. You know, maybe some snake guns. Maybe a new little concealed carry piece. Anyway, gang. That's we'll turn back to the main hall here, because that's the whole show. That is all 4 days of the Collector Firearms Auction. That is, and we made it. That is all 11,200 Collector Firearms. That is 4 days of Collector Firearms and accessories and books and art and ammo and leather tack and accessories and books. So much that obviously you can't hope to cover in what is already like a 23-minute video. So thanks for spending some time with us this morning. Hope you enjoyed it. Like I said, we are open to the public. So y'all come on down. We'll show you a real good time. In fact, if you come down, you see her from YouTube, I'll give you a tour. We'll show you a little bit of a behind the scenes action there in the warehouse and just kind of what we do here. And I think you'd be impressed. If 11,200 guns wasn't impressive enough already. So thanks for spending some time with us this morning. Again, if you can't make it, check out rockislandauction.com. You can place a sealed bid on just about anything you like. And if you get any questions, give us a call. Until next time, everybody, y'all keep your powder dry.